Is TEDx the platform to deliver one's dream? I really hope so, because today I do not come on stage as a researcher. I come to share my dream. And this dream is actually this treasure box. This box can connect you with life, can make you free, can serve as a tool set to cope with almost any situation in life. And the beauty of my dream is that it is a realistic one, because this box is already yours. So my dream is not only to you, it's not a gift only to you, it's also to all children here in Mauritius and all around the world, as it contains your senses. Now, senses, we don't really know much about them, do we? We have this treasure and we neglect it. Why? Probably because we're lazy. Click here and you get almost no surprise. Whereas now, if you start using your senses and this box, you open a bouquet of sensations, always different. That's one reason. Another reason is because we hardly know about them. Who taught us, who educated us to use our senses, and what were our senses about? So my wish is here to share with you a little knowledge on our senses, but as well as to question some unexplored spaces of those senses. Senses are like superpowers that connects you to life and makes you connected by life. So you're connected to the environment, and this interaction is all the time unique, each minute, each second, because the environment keeps on changing all the time. It's never the same. Although you feel it's the same, it's not the same. It's changing, but you are unique as well, because you are sensorially unique, because you have your own combination of receptors, absolutely unique to history. So the way you interact through your senses makes this interaction, each interaction, unique. And the other thing is that this connection can be rather local. Let's see, if I taste, I have this local feeling. If I touch, and then at a distance, then I can see, hear. Those are distant senses. Now, in terms of this idea of senses, why five senses, and this whole thing, where does it come from? It dates back from long, long time ago in the history, from Aristotle, during the antiquity. He wrote a book called De Anima. Animus in Latin is soul in English. So basically, he was studying what animates us, this sparkle of life. And that's when he coined our five senses and this idea of senses. That was version 5 of our box. But since then, we've incremented our box. It has come to version 20 and even maybe 33, because some people say we have 33 senses. So I'm not going to list them. But I will share with you 3 examples. One is a sense of your body, the positioning of your body in space. Pretty useful to do whatever you do in life. A second one is actually very useful when you don't want to get lost. It is your sense of direction, your GPS, own GPS sense. Another one that I'm not favorite, not my favorite one, is the sense of time passing by. Not nice. Yet, in terms of frequency, how often do we use our senses? Are we regular users, super users, or lazy one? Let's consider blind individuals. Some can't see, but some of them are definitely super users of their senses. And same goes with other handicap. Now, Claude Monet, he painted a number of his greatest masterpieces when he had lost one eye and could hardly see from the other one. Complete hearing loss did not prevent Beethoven to compose one of his greatest masterpieces, the Ninth Symphony. Da, 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 da. So it seems as though we hear when we don't, we see when we don't. So as if we had a parallel world of unexplored senses not connecting through our expected organs. That's something that is also interesting. There may be two reasons for that. One is probably because, after all, we are building up our senses using a combination of our memory and our imagination. That could be. Another possibility is that, after all, we don't know. It's an unexplored area of our box. Let's consider the first hypothesis. But on this one, I need you to engage with me on a common sensorial experience. May I invite you to use your imagination and to follow me onto this castle, this very old castle in the center of France, dating back from the 14th century, destroyed twice, rebuilt twice. And during the 19th century, Georges Sand, a famous French writer, is living in there to avoid a smallpox epidemic. Now, please, I invite you to close your eyes and just imagine her as she's sneaking in every corner of this castle, entering rooms after room, enters one and feels very much attracted by some red rugs, crappy, dusty, but she feels so attracted. What are those red rugs about? You may open your eyes. Those red rugs, as five tapestries, our five senses, dating back from the Middle Ages, the most brilliant of our history, full of colors, of mille fleurs, hypnotic patterns of mille fleurs, and with wild and domestic animals, we are real like a lion, and imaginary animals like unicorn, one to two ladies sitting on a piece of land that looks like an island. What are the unexplored spaces of our five senses, if any? The lady is now playing the organ. She's got a sumptuous dress, a gorgeous necklace, and a wonderful hairstyle. In order that you easily can connect with an unexplored space of hearing, I invite you once more to sort of picture how you were connected to sound during 9 months when you were in your mother's womb. And take, if you don't really realize, take a balloon. Please do it one day. Take a balloon and stand by someone who is playing the music. And suddenly you will feel the intensity of the vibration that goes between the palms of your hands. And those vibrations, not only your ears get them, but every cell of your body. That's a connection to sound through other part of your body. Second tapestry. The lady is holding a mirror in which the smiley unicorn is reflecting herself. Have you ever sensed one day some, you know, faces in the back, in your back, whether they were angry or smiley? Maybe you have, maybe you have not. But I can tell you that such sense exists, as it has been demonstrated once more in blind individuals who get a specific part of their brain activated on the emotion of faces that they can see without eyes, that we can see without eyes. Unexplored space of tasting now. The lady is taking a little sweet, gives it to a parrot. And in fact, taste is about the strongest muscle of all that you have, your tongue. Taste informs you whether it's sweet, whether it's salty, fair enough, but it also informs you about more locally what's going on internally. Whether you feel stressed, you may feel the bitter taste in your mouth, or whether you feel sick and then you lose taste. Unexplored space of touching. My favorite tapestry, the touch as the essence of all senses. She's holding the wood, the stick of the flag with one hand, and the horn of the unicorn with the other hand. Both feel like wood. And she and we know through touching whether it is that of the object or that of a living creature. Because touch teaches you life. Touch is really informative to the communication on life. Another one, smelling. Full of flowers and a little monkey next to the lady with smelling a rose. Charming. And also puzzling, because people keep on saying that animals are better than us at smelling. Don't we hear it all the time? Don't we think it ourselves? But this is wrong. This is again because we're not taught. You and I can discriminate over a trillion smells. That's quite impressive. That's who we are. And not only that, but we have to understand how this can be. And this can go through weak smells. Take 30 women. 15 never had a baby. 15 already had a baby. You expose them to a scent that they don't know of. But they all describe it as weak, unfamiliar, mildly pleasant. And in their brain, they get a reward circuitry activated. All 30 women get this reward. On what scent is it? Because it is mildly pleasant. Because it is the scent of a two-day-old baby. The power of caring through weak smells. And if you shake hands with a stranger, you will smell your hand unconsciously. The power of caring through smells. That's quite impressive after, you know, exploring unexplored spaces of only five senses. Now, it is believed that we have a sixth sense, that the sixth sense may be actually more important than the other ones. Some people say it is our intuition. Some people don't really know, because in fact, there is no such thing as a consensus or as a definition on a sixth sense. And so today, using a combination of art, science, and empirical observation, I will share with you for the very first time what I believe is our sixth sense and its organ. But first, let me explain how I picture this whole cartoon of senses. They can either be felt at a distance or locally. Now, if the signal is chemical, at a distance, you smell. Locally, you taste. If the signal is mechanical, at a distance, you hear. Locally, you touch. At a distance, if it is electromagnetic signal, you see. And locally, nothing. Empty box. Could it be that there was nothing here? No paired sense? Or could it be our missing sense? First piece of the puzzle. Second piece comes from art. Yes, there was a sixth tapestry. But the thing is that this sixth tapestry is a mysterious. And this tapestry helped me a lot to come up with my proposal. So, yes, indeed, we cannot really see anything because it is not relating to any sort of sensorial experience. The lady is standing before a tent. Right. Let's zoom further. Oh my God, what's going on to our lady? Her hair is poorly combed, and she's now returning her jewels into a treasure box. What has the sign of those jewels, of getting rid of the appearance to get to the essential? Let's zoom further. The tent is emblazoned with three words, mon seul désir. And suddenly, those three words clicked in my mind with the secret, and found an echo with the secret of the little prince. On ne voit bien qu'avec le cœur. It is only with the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the eye. Invisible to the eye. An open tent to the invisible. Mon seul désir, love and beloved, my sole desire. And obviously, the sixth sense is about love. And empirically, we all know that the organ for our love is our heart. Now, through art, we understand that entering this tent is like entering a hosting heart where you get your free will makes you want or not to get rid of the essential, to get in the truth. In the truth of love, not only the romantic love, but the caring love, the love for one another. Now, from science, we know that love is a local sense. That's from this cartoon now. A local sense because, indeed, if I want to love somebody, I need to meet that person in person. And our two electromagnetic fields of our two hearts get connected then, and only then. That's the way it is. So heart is our utmost sensory organ, and heart is as well our most vital organ, since it is the very first to develop as an embryo and start beating. And will beat till the end of your life, connecting this beat and the rhythm of it to everything that's around you, to the emotion of everyone around you, and to your own emotion. Love, this powerful feeling. Now, those two, and this actually will take place whether your brain has agreed on that, or whether you're conscious or not. But now, if we see the pairing between the sight and the love through electromagnetic signals, we realize that sight means light, when love means glow, the glow of love, the glow of holy people, just as if they emitted light. Light is made of photons. So what would love be made of? My proposal is that love is made of amourons. And amourons emit shining sparkles that are poured as a shower upon the fusion of our parental genomes, and that makes us be alive and stay alive because no one can live without love. And now you understand that this sixth sense is integrating remarkably all the senses, and so you may use it as your intuition, because indeed it will lead you to what is true, far from the appearance, far from any screens, in a reality that matters to be alive. That's our treasure box. And you have it in all your hands now. It is all up to you to make this love fruitful and emit amourons and more amourons and more and more, or to let it shrink and die. So I prompt you, I invite you so strongly to tell everyone around you that you have this treasure, that you're welcome to open it and to connect yourself to life, to love, to truth. This is my dream for the people here, for all children here and all around the world. This is my dream, my sole desire. Thank you.